Yo, there's only one Tyson Fury, one Tyson Fury. No belt on his waist, they say, that's a disgrace. Rematch, give the time and place. There's only one Tyson Fury, one Tyson Fury. No more fat slob, they say he got robbed. Rematch, it's time to do your job. There's only one Tyson Fury. Let's get down. Doma Sports Talk, worldwide. With some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, we done had a day in between, day and a half, you know, and everything going down. I'm going to tell you straight up, I still ain't watched the fight again. Tyson Fury, Deontay Wilder's name. Well, watch the fight again. Got things to do. Gonna get to it because I'm gonna watch it and I'm gonna score it. Take my time. Go back and then I'm gonna get with y'all on that. But it's all about the residue, baby. It's all about the residue. Now, and what I'm checking out is America. Pay attention how you hype or respect your fighters. Pay attention, right? Because listen, you know, you see all the articles. You know, Fury is the big winner here. His fight's the draw. Fury is the big winner here, right? And, you know, you see in most of the articles, especially coming out of Britain, most of the articles, but out of everywhere. But Britain, definitely, you know, it's like, hey, you know, this is like the greatest resurrection seen in the history of boxing. The greatest resurrection seen in the history of boxing. With everything that happened, let me just ask the question first before we go into that. Did anybody do anything to Tyson Fury? Right? Anybody do anything to Tyson Fury? Right? As much as I like Tyson Fury, but I got to be objective. No. Everything that happened to Tyson Fury was self-inflicted. Right? You got fat on your own. Nobody asked you to get fat. You took drugs on your own, the cocaine. Nobody told you to do that. And them other ones that people are not paying attention to, that other stuff, that Nandrolene and all that other drugs that the him and his cousin said, hey, well, that's because we eat wild boar. Right? They did the old Canelo excuse thing. All those things. Now, the depression, we're going to give them a slide because anybody can get depressed. You know what I'm saying? We ain't going to say, but I'm saying these are self-inflicted. It's not like, you know, you're pushing up on Muhammad Ali, who said, I ain't going to no war because no Vietnamese called me no nigga. Right? Right? And it's just, listen, that was in the 60s, now, wasn't it? Now, doesn't it seem like Michael Jackson would be proud of how Donald Trump then moonwalked us back into the 60s? Michael Jackson be asking, man, where'd y'all learn how to moonwalk so good? Because what we're going through right now is just like we're living in the 60s. Exactly. But I ain't going to go into politics right now. But I'm just saying. So that was something that was inflicted because of some injustices. So you don't want to push up on that. This ain't nothing the best in ever history. The dude had some problems and came back from them, like most people going to do. That's called resilience and survival. Right? But it's cool. It's, you know, nice to see him come back, but you got fat. So, you know, you go to Weight Watchers, you find a whole bunch of people that have done that before. Right? And when it's money involved, that's some incentive. So let's not go overboard with all the props about losing weight. Right? And getting back into it. The man is 6'9 and an awesome fighter. So I mean, you know, I don't like to, you know, let's go overboard about whatever thing he did. Right? Now I'm hearing about the judge, you know, they want to, you know, investigate the judge. Like the judge that scored at 115-111 for Wilder is really so out there. Like I said in my other video, like the Canelo judge scoring at 118-110. And with Mayweather, it got him a draw with Mayweather in 118-110 against GGG and those kind of things. That's investigation, right? Then you hear about, you know, you're hearing about, hey, well, I would have said nothing, right? This is what Tyson Fury said. I would have said nothing. It could have been a riot, right? Oh, it could have been a riot. He stopped the riot. Now, the funny thing about these riots and stuff, you know, when brothers, we get cheated so much, we don't even be thinking about riot. You know what we do? We go home and just complain because it's another brother got cheated. You know, riots, right? Now, let me just say some injustice. Remember when Tim Bradley got a decision over Manny Pacquiao? You know, he got a decision over Manny Pacquiao, Tim Bradley, in a fight that was actually close. But like I told you guys back then, somebody who was at that fight that saw that Tim Bradley sprained both ankles, both, not one, both ankles, and still had the resilience to stay in the fight and try to fight Manny Pacquiao to a close decision. Somebody there might, who doesn't see color at all, might have just said, had a little sympathy for the guy who is totally injured, fighting a legend. They might have said, well, you know, shoot, man, if that round was a draw, hey, maybe I gave it to this guy here because he's definitely hobbled on both ankles. Only people just like, man, I don't care what he was wrong with him. Man, shoot, I don't care. Brother, he's supposed to be good, right? He's supposed to be good, right? You know, so things like that. And then what was the outrage? Outrage against Tim Bradley getting a decision. So much so that Tim Bradley goes gets death threats because of a decision. Death threats. Right? And then comes out of there and damn near commits suicide trying to fight your boy from Russia, Povotnikov, standing in a pocket with Povotnikov all over there. Because somebody go watch that fight. That's because somebody have given him death threats. He gonna go out here and fight Povotnikov like that, damn near lose his mind. His wife almost left him because of that. You better not get in the ring, do no stupid stuff like that again. Are you crazy? Right? It was a good fight for people who like to see stuff like that. But I'm glad Tim Bradley still has his faculties after a fight like that. Those are the kind of things, you know, outrage. Dillian White and Joseph Parker, you know, Dillian White doing every transgression in boxing, doesn't get docked a point, damn near knocked out at the end. Joseph Parker just goes home and, like, you know, he ain't complaining. He ain't complaining. Like, all right, whatever, I'll get him next time when I get a shot. So things we see every week. Stop acting like, you know, Tyson Fury got robbed. First of all, the champion, right, knocked him down twice and wasn't dominated so much between the fight, right? Dominated. If it was, then we're looking at people's faces, whose faces messed up. Deontay Wilder's eye and Tyson Fury was peppered everywhere on his face. Everywhere on his face. And let me tell you something about that peppered on his face. Those peppers on his face were before the knockdowns. So I have all these, this phantom, like Deontay Wilder never hit him or wasn't even in the fight if he didn't knock him down. That's a myth. And that's without me going to see it. Going, because I know that I didn't judge those first six rounds for Tyson Fury, not all of them. And he, the Deontay fanboy or whatever, you want to call somebody. It's just like, that's not how it works. It's just like, no, I wasn't sitting there waiting for Deontay Wilder to lose, right? I wasn't sitting there hoping that Deontay Wilder lost. That's probably the difference, right? But if he were, then everything that the other dude do is the bomb, right? So this thing about this is the greatest resurrection and comeback in history, no, it ain't. The dude just basically, I'm going to go get that money. And Deontay Wilder ain't going to say that I ain't never coming back, which motivated him to come back, which is good. So America, pay attention to how you hype your fighters and respect what they do. Because listen, when we're looking at Wilder, right? When we're looking at Wilder, we can't say, you know, things like, hey, man, the dude started 19 years old because his daughter was sick. The fight for her. Put that in priority. Say that about this guy. Say, guy, you know, is not that technically sound, but winning all his fights per knockout. You can be saying that right now. You can also say, hey, you know what? Deontay Wilder is beating up guys that's an average of 30 to 40 or 50 pounds heavier than him in every single fight. Isn't that awesome? Listen to all these other weight divisions where people won't even budge. The middleweights, juggernaut who you lied about having the best knockout ratio in boxing like Golovkin. He ain't even going up to 168 from 160. These guys ain't budging, right? You got a heavyweight who has not fought nobody in his weight class recently, but still knocking him out. There's something you could put in the forefront. What about this one? Hey, you know what Deontay Wilder just did? Something that Vladimir Klitschko couldn't do. Reigning 10 years in a row. Vladimir Klitschko couldn't even touch this guy. Landed 50 punches in 12 rounds. 50 punches, lowest in heavyweight history. This guy knocks him down twice. Right? It's about perspective, perception, right? We can be hyping that right now. The American guy at least did this against the lineal champion who's untouchable, bigger than him, weighs 44 pounds more than he does. He had also a good showing. Didn't get frustrated and continued to believe in himself. So guys, listen, put the brakes on it. Both of these guys were awesome. Just like I said in my last video, it's about how you trying to see it. And listen, I don't watch The Walking Dead. Right? I don't watch because I don't like zombie stuff. Right? And plus, you can watch Society and see The Walking Dead. Stop following people and get your own opinion. Look at it yourself and get your own opinion and stop following people. Right? You don't do what everyone does. Do what's right. Domo Sports Talk. Worldwide. And I'm up out of here, y'all.